Hi everyone, it's Megan, the education intern at the Smithsonian Marine Ecosystems Exhibit at the St. Lucie County Aquarium, and I'm back today with another activity that you can do at home. So the activity I'm going to be sharing today is called Invent an Invertebrate. This is a great activity to get to explore the diverse world of invertebrates. Invertebrates are animals that don't have a backbone and they don't have any bones in their bodies. So they have different unique ways to support their bodies. We have a skeleton to hold us upright, but invertebrates have to get really creative with how they support themselves and move around in their environment. Invertebrates are some of the most diverse animals on our planet. 95% of known species are actually invertebrates. So most of the animals that we know of, that scientists know of, actually don't have any bones at all. So today in this activity, we're gonna dive into the world of invertebrates and we're gonna create our own and explain what makes that animal unique. I'm going to show you some of the materials that you can use and talk just a little bit about the process of how you can invent your invertebrate. And then I'll show you the one that I have made as well. Another one of those activities where you can use any craft supplies. There is no set material list for this one. The only thing you really need for this is our worksheet that is attached to the activity guide. That's going to help you explore and create your invertebrate and get to know a little bit more about the animal that you're creating. So to create my invertebrate, I just used whatever I had around the house. I used some plastic cups, some yarn today, some glue or tape. This is going to be important to get stuff to stick to your invertebrate. Some modeling clay, pipe cleaners, little bamboo skewers or toothpicks if you've got them, some buttons. You can use sequins, googly eyes, pom-poms, anything like that that you want to use to create your invertebrate. And then again, a pair of scissors. Make sure you are asking for adult help if you need it. So now that I've got all my supplies, I am going to create my invertebrate and I'll check back in to show you what I have made up. I have created. I'm going to talk a little bit about the adaptations that I picture this animal would have to help protect itself and how it would live in its environment. So first thing you may notice, it's got all these dangly strings down at the bottom. These are tentacles that my invertebrate has that have stingers on them. So this is how my invertebrate defends itself when it feels threatened. It can use these stingers to keep predators away from it. Also notice it's got these two little orange. These are gonna act like fins to help my invertebrate if it needs to. It can swim away with these fins. And then you might notice I've got two little eyes on stalks. So this whole thing is a hard shell that my invertebrate lives in. And these eyes can actually go back into the shell if it's feeling threatened. And I have decided that my invertebrate can see images. It can see really well. So that's how it hunts, using its eyesight to move around and find its prey. And then on the outside, I've got all of this orange sort of armor. So it's nice and scaled and protected. This is a hardy little creature that won't be easily attacked because he's got plate armor as well. And then on the top of my invertebrate, I added two buttons. And these are false eye spots. So they kind of, you know, I use buttons for these eyes. And I put some on top, and this is so an animal might think that it's got these big eyes that's watching you. So if you're swimming above my invertebrate and you see these two big eyes, you're gonna think I'm not gonna attack that because it'll see me and it'll run away. So these are some of the adaptations that I gave my invertebrate. I would love to see what you all have come up with. So don't forget to share your creation and the worksheet that goes along with it so we can know about the creature you've created. I want to thank you all so much for joining me today. I can't wait to see your creations, and I hope that you all stay healthy out there. Have a great day.